thank you for coming out. Before we start to play the first piece, I wanted to mention the subtitle for Rejouissance is A Fantasia over Ein Feste Burg, which we know in English as Almighty Father, Mighty Fortress. A Mighty Fortress is our God. So if you hear a tune that you recognize, you actually do recognize.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, so, I need to catch my breath. So, thank you again for coming. Last Sunday, I decided to come down with COVID. So, we're recovering and we're feeling okay, but we need to wear a mask and not infect anybody. So, the next piece is also based, it's based on a poem by Rilke, German poet, and also you'll hear the same tune, Ein Feste Burg, kind of quoted in the piece, very, very different piece. Just as that one was really, really fast, the next one is really, really slow, really slow. So just, you know, and it's based on a poem. I was going to read the German and show off, but I won't. So this is, the leaves are falling as from way off, as though from far gardens withered in the skies. They are falling with denying gestures. And in the nights, the heavy earth is falling from all the stars down into loneliness. We are all falling. This hand falls. And look at others. It is in them all. And yet, there is one hand who holds his falling endlessly, gently, in his hands. So this is The Leaves Are Falling. And again, it's very it's very slow, contemplative, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's a really challenging work, so I don't know whether you could tell, but it's some really interesting rhythms in there, and it's so slow. So anyway, the next piece, Bach Passacaglia and Fugue, is one of the great, great masterworks in European music. It's an extraordinary piece. It's one of my favorite pieces, and so I'm really delighted to get it. It's written for organ originally, and it's a Passacaglia. So what's a Passacaglia? So, okay, what's a Passacaglia? Don't all answer at once. There is going to be a quiz, I don't know if you know, but so a Passacaglia, it's a slow dance, and it's a ground bass. So you'll hear, one reason I picked this was the last two pieces were kind of based on music of a given tune. And then the Passacaglia, now this is a tune from the composer that he comes up with, and it's called a ground, and you'll hear it goes all the way through the first half of the piece. Right? It goes all the way through. It's this present, and he's writing all these variations. Now, there are times when it gets really hidden, and you can't really tell, but it's really there. And so it's this masterwork of just somehow they make eight bars with the same tune and make it interesting, and he does. And then the second half is a fugue, and a fugue is a type of counterpoint music that starts in the late Renaissance, early Baroque, and is played in the Baroque, and then kind of was a challenge of all the composers, Mozart, Beethoven, their challenge was to be able to write a fugue. Beethoven's last piece, the Große Fuge, I think, was a fugue. So a fugue is, you have a tune, right? And then it answers at a different tonal level. And so and then he takes that tune and he weaves it all through. Sometimes you hear it, sometimes you don't. But that would be too simple. So on the fugue, not only is there that, the subject that you hear at the very beginning of the piece, he also writes another fugue subject, ba dum dum dim dum da dum dum. So that's going on at the same time as that other fugue subject is going on. And then that would be too simple, because then he adds a counter subject that after the first time you hear the fugue subject, you hear da di da di da di da di da, you hear these running 16th notes bouncing along. And that's kind of all the time you hear the fugue subject, you have that. And if that's not cool, you know, it's already complex enough. He adds to that. There's all this wild numerology in Bach that we could spend hours talking about. Like he has this name, 2138 BACH, right? That's his name, right? And he spells out 14. There's all sorts of places where you find that. Those of you who play piano, the three-part inventions, the last invention is in 9/16th time or 9/8th time, 9/16th time. And if you multiply that by the number of measures, you get 21 and 3/8. 2138. I mean, it's like this wild stuff. And what he does in this piece, and you won't really hear it, right in the exact middle of the fugue, there's a bass line of A natural, B flat, B natural, and C, right? What's the big deal about that, you ask? Well, the big deal is that if you're in German, if the names of the notes are not the way we call them, so A would be A, B flat would be B, bay, and B natural is not B natural, it's H. And then C is C. So you have A, get where we're going? B, H, C. So exact middle of the fugue, he spells out his name in the bass line. So it's like, and he had 20 kids and he wrote over, you know, it's just mind-boggling. The numerology and the, you know, this, if Psalm 115, there'll be 115 notes in the flute part. I mean, it's just crazy stuff. So anyway, I've talked long enough, but this is the Bach Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor.
Thank you. arrived getting sick. We missed a rehearsal Wednesday. So we're going to start that again because people are a little confused. And I'm a little confused, so let's just... I was once at a concert in Munich, and they started this Munich Philharmonic, and I can't remember, it was a French cellist, and they start, and then he stops because he didn't like the tempo. So I figured if the Munich Philharmonic can stop, Fox Valley Concert Band can stop.
Thank you.
Thank you. I had the great good fortune to play under and study with Dr. Harry Beejan at the University of Illinois. And he said, you know, back in the day, if you wanted to be a band director, you had to love marches. Things have changed, but I still love marches, and that's a great one. Julius Fuchsik, he's also March of the Glad. He wrote that one, so he's written lots of things. So anyway, so that was the Florintiner March. The next piece, Lyric for Band, is a transcription. It was originally called Lyric for Strings, so obviously for strings, by George Walker. And I really was hoping to find a piece. There's a lot of neglected music, and it was neglected or not played simply because the composer wasn't a white male, right? Either women composers, women of color. And I got to hear this, and I was looking for a slow piece, and I went to Midwest Convention, thanks to a grant from our Professional Development Committee and our foundation, which supports the faculty here, which I'm very grateful for, so thanks to them. But in Chicago, yeah, they're really great. It's really wonderful to be that kind of support, and it is appreciated. So I got to hear this piece, the Marine Band played this piece, and it was a slow piece. I was looking for a slow piece for the program, and it was by George Walker, who was the first African-American to win the Pulitzer Prize. He won that in 1996. You would have thought that Duke Ellington would have won it, but it didn't happen. So this is just, we hope you like this. This is Lyric for Band. Thank you. Gee, we're at the end of the show. I don't know how that happens. I'm sure the band feels like the program is plenty long enough. So before I talk about the last piece, thank you again for coming out. My deepest thanks. I feel so fortunate and lucky to be able to work with this group of people. They're really wonderful, and it's just, it's a real blessing for me. So my thanks to the band. And they know me that I wouldn't just say it to be nice, because I'm not that nice, so. And then the other thing is, as we've done in the past, you will see some large baritone saxophone cases that we no longer need to use, because we were able to buy new baritone saxophone cases that have wheels. And we were able to do that with the generous donations that we've collected from our concerts and from other sources, people who have donated to the music program. So if you feel so inclined and you have something that you want to share and you can donate, please do so. I should let you know that, I mean, as you've probably heard, the University of Wisconsin system is in a lot of turmoil, or the universities of Wisconsin are in a lot of turmoil. You know, we just not have enough funding. And so the Fond du Lac campus is closed, the Waukesha campus is closed. We have our fingers crossed that the Fox Cities campus will not be closing, but it certainly is on the table, and which is would be horribly tragic for our community, I think. But the hope is, though, that we are just, so why are you donating money? So that in case, if both in ongoing with the university, we receive, the only funding we get from the university is my salary, because this does count as part of my teaching load. But otherwise, we've been for the last 7-8 years using the money that we collect in order to buy new music, pay for soloists, and the other expenses that we have. So if you can, please feel free to donate. If you can't, please don't feel guilty. This is we love sharing our music with you. So the last piece, whole suite number 1 in E flat is maybe the first 20th century classic written in the first part of the 20th century, although not performed apparently until the 1920s, with a really large band. Everybody thinks it's a small group. It's actually a very large band. But anyway, but one reason I picked it was the Chaconne is very similar to the Passacgalia. It starts out with a bass line, and then you have that repeated over and over, and then variations there upon it. He also, Holst does something interesting in the middle of this piece. He goes, you know, because the da-dee-da-dee-da, and you didn't come here to hear me sing, so I won't sing anymore, but he takes that melody, and Baroque composers would do that as well as Renaissance composers, and he turns it around, he goes backwards. So instead of going up, he goes down, da-dee-da, and he gets a whole completely different melody. And then another melody comes in with the same, but starting on the third of the tune instead of the root, and so gives you a whole different melody, but kind of the same shape of the melody. And so, and then that tune is kind of the core, uses that for the rest of the other two movements as well, which is one reason why I wanted to do this in the Bach Passacaglia, because that similar compositional techniques which composers are using. You're not necessarily supposed to even hear them, but that's what's kind of the structure that's holding the piece together. This is one of the great, great pieces in our repertoire. We've all played it over and over again, and it's one of those things that it just never gets tired. It's probably like those of you who like Star Wars and you've seen first Star Wars 18 times and looking for the next 97 or whatever. So anyway, so this is the whole suite number 1 in E flat.